Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Dear brothers and sisters, may Allah accept your siyam and your qiyam. And our parable for today is from Surah At-Tawbah, verse 109. It says, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم أَفَمَنْ أَسَّسَ بُنْيَانَهُ عَلَى تَقْوَى مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانِ خَيْرٌ أَمْ مَنْ أَسَّسَ بُنْيَانَهُ عَلَى شَفَى جُرُفٍ هَارٍ فَانْهَارَ بِهِ فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمْ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Translation, is he who founded his building upon God consciousness and his good pleasure better, or he who founded his building on the brink of crumbling overhanging precipice so that it topples with him into fire of hell? God guideth not wrongdoers, folks. So here we have a parable, an example, analogy, very clear, like day and night, like black and white, between the believers and the hypocrites. And the question is, who is better? The one who built his house, his building, on a solid ground, level, strong, or that one who builds an exotic building, full of scenes and glamour, but where? On the edge of a cliff. We have seen a lot of people build their homes on the edge of a cliff, and we see the mudslides, and we see the earthquakes, and how those buildings are crumbling down to the ocean or to the valley. The answer is very obvious. The one who builds his building on solid ground, level, strong foundations, his building will be safe, secure, and he can enjoy it for a long time. The context of this ayah is for those who wanted to build Masjid Dirar. And the intention wasn't good. They were hypocrites. They wanted to create troubles, their hearts full of malice and hatred, and so on. For us, this picture help us to decide the course of our lives. Which is better, to live a decent life, a life of dignity and honor, a life which is solid, families, children, future, or to go astray, experiment with cigarettes and alcohol and sex and all what we see around us, drugs and crimes, suicide, homicide. Which is better, a life, this one or that one? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا يَضِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى. When you follow the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you follow the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in yourself, your family, your children, you have a better life, a life of cleanliness, a life of dignity, a life of security, a life of future, while those who turn their backs towards God and His commandments, they will suffer. Examples are abundant around us. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. His life will be miserable. It's very clear cut as day and night and as white and black. So we need to take a lesson from this beautiful parable that we should build our lives on taqwa, build our life on the fear and the love of God and His commandments, and follow the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah bless you all. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.